Hi friends, today we'll see if your username and password is leaked online. Your email ID and password is as safe as the security of the website where you have registered. You'll be surprised to know that even famous websites database is hacked regularly. For example, Adobe database was hacked and 7.5 million users credential was leaked online. LinkedIn database was hacked and more than 167 million account credentials were leaked. The same with Dropbox, the most widely used cloud for storage, was hacked and 68 million user passwords were leaked. Attackers get into the database, get the database dump of users from these websites, and they dump it online for everyone to see. There are two ways to store your password in database. One is as a plain text, and if that gets leaked, your actual password is leaked everywhere. And the other way is to store a hash. Whenever you register, your password is hashed and encrypted password is stored in the database. That's only one way. You can't decrypt those passwords. Next time you log in, your password is again hashed and checked with the one in database, and if it matches, you are allowed to log in. Now, if this database gets leaked, only your hashed password is leaked and not the actual plain text. Whenever you try to register, you are encouraged to make the password more complex by adding special characters and uppercase letters and not use dictionary words. That makes it even more difficult for hackers to guess and find it online. So there are more than 454 websites that have been hacked recently. 10 billion accounts password is leaked online. And if you have account in any of those 454 websites, then most probably your email ID and password is also leaked online. Now to find out where your password is hacked, you have to go to a website called haveibeenpwned.com. A guy named Troy Hunt has created this website and he has gathered all leaked password online and has stored it in his database. If you click on who's been pwned, you see a host of websites that has its database breached. And if you have registered to any of the sites here, then your credential could be compromised. You can verify whether your email ID or password is leaked online by just going to this site and entering your email ID. For example, if I enter my email ID, it'll say whether my email ID is pwned or not. So it's saying it has found my email ID in 10 breached sites. It'll also show which all sites database that were leaked online had my email ID and password. So it's saying my email ID was in Adobe, Bitly, Canva, Discuss, Forbes, and LinkedIn, among others. Now, your email ID is leaked doesn't mean your password is also leaked. Maybe because if it's a hash password and a strong password, the attacker might not be able to guess what the password is. But as I said, if a database of a website which stores plain password is also hacked, then many would know your password. So to search that, go to password and see if your password is also leaked. And it's saying it even that has been seen 3 times before. Now this is very serious because online anyone can search my email ID and get the password. Now the next question is how to safeguard it. And how to make sure you don't get affected if database is hacked somewhere. Now for that you have to have 3 types of password. One for sites that are not so famous. So they might be storing password as plain text. And even if that gets leaked, your other 2 types of account won't be impacted. The second password is for sites like Gmail, Facebook, LinkedIn. They store hash password and you have to store a better password in these so that the hashed password cannot be guessed. And finally, a very tough different password for your bank accounts. So even if other databases are leaked, your bank account's password is different. And also make sure to use social media login instead of creating your own username and password. So even if this site's database gets leaked, it will not have your password because you haven't created any. Your password won't be leaked because this site won't be storing your password, but just reference to your social media. And of course, keep changing your password to a completely new password once in a while, which anyway the banks force you to do it. One more thing you can do is enable two-factor authentication if the websites provide. Gmail provides it, Facebook, LinkedIn, and many other sites provide it as well. So if you have that, make sure to enable it. That's it, guys. Hope you learned something new today. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you in another video soon. Till then, have a nice time.